And those of you who have Bibles, please take your Bible and turn to 1 John chapter 3. I'll give you a hint. It's on the front of your bulletins, this verse. But I'd like you to see it in your own Bible. 1 John chapter 3 and verse 16. I think it's really interesting how many times that group, that chapter, and that verse are kind of special and significant. 3:16. It happens quite a few times. But anyway, in 1 John chapter 3 and verse 16, it says, "By this we know love, because he," that's Jesus Christ, "laid down his life for us." And so we saw that. We mentioned that earlier, that Jesus said, this is how you, the greatest love, this is how you show your love, you lay down your life. Now, there, lay down your life is speaking about death. And the Bible gives us two ways that we can die as Christians. We can die a physical death, and then we will be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord, and that is a wonderful thing. Okay, for the believer who's been forgiven in Christ. And the welcome for the Christian who's been faithful, I can't even imagine that. So, but we stand before him accepted, not because of what we do, but because of what Jesus has done for us. And then there's another kind that Jesus actually did before he went to the cross. In the Garden of Gethsemane, we see the Lord Jesus speaking to his Father and say, "Lord, if it's possible, let this cup pass from me." And so we ask him, and he asked him, and the Father evidently said, no, there's not another way that people can be saved and have eternal life. And so Jesus said, "Nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done." That's when Jesus died to his own desires, his own choices. He died there and surrendered it to the Father. Now, this is a hard way to go, too. And we remember those who actually gave their lives. They gave up their lives. But everyone who went into warfare, in a sense, died before they left home. I've mentioned that my son, who is in the Army, he's a captain, and he flies Black Hawk pilots in Hawaii. What a life, you know? It's not I said, "That's when you go start sacrificing, son." And no, I didn't say. But when he was in college in the ROTC, he went to Key West. That sounds like a party too, doesn't it? But no, they had underwater combat training, and there they taught them how to survive some horrible things. And they would put them underwater, and they would tie them up, and they would take their air supply, and this is like 40 feet underwater in a pool, you know, and they would pummel them, and they would turn them upside down, and they could not lose their cool. They could not panic. They had to learn that. And my son said, "Dad, it became easy when I understood this. You just have to be willing to die. And once you're willing to die, then you can do it. If you're hanging on to life and you're scared you're going to lose it, you cannot do this. You have to be willing to die." I thought, that's my little boy saying that? My goodness. But Christians, this is the Christian life. In order for you to live the Christian life, you've got to be willing to die. Jesus went to the Garden of Gethsemane and said, "Not my will, but thine be done. I want this, I would like that, I would, you know, enjoy doing this." No, Christian. Your Father is so good, he's given us so many things to enjoy. But the desire of his heart is that you let him be God. And to do that, we not only die, in the sense with Christ, when we trust him, to get out of this world, not only will we have to die, to give up this earthly mortal body to put on the immortal, but every day, like the Apostle Paul, we need to say, "I die daily." I want to look at one more passage, and that's in Philippians in chapter 2. Philippians chapter 2. Now, Paul's telling a story about a soldier. And Memorial Day, we should remember soldiers, shouldn't we? And so verse 25 of Philippians chapter 3, and I'm not going to comment very much on this because we just don't have time, but I encourage you to read this passage and think about this man, Epaphroditus. And so Paul said, "Yet I considered it necessary to send to you Epaphroditus, my brother, fellow worker, and fellow soldier." You know the old hymn, "Onward, Christian soldiers." Well, Epaphroditus, Christian soldier. We are on a mission in this world. "But your messenger, and the one who ministered to my needs, since he was longing for you all and was distressed because you had heard that he was sick." The opening song, "Letters from War." You know, I mean, here we have a mother who is writing to her son, and then the letters stop, and she's just, you know, he's missing in action. You know, what a horrible thing that must be, the unknown. And so these people in Philippi, they didn't know what was happening with Epaphroditus. And he was sick, and they were worried about him. Verse 27, "For indeed he was sick almost unto death." This was not a common cold. This was something that could end up in death, okay? "But God had mercy on him, and not only on him, but me also, lest I should have sorrow upon sorrow. Therefore I sent him the more eagerly, that when you see him again, you may rejoice, and I may be less sorrowful. Receive him, therefore, in the Lord with all gladness, and hold such men in esteem." Isn't that what we're doing on Memorial Day? People we haven't ever met, we're esteeming them. "Because for the work of Christ, he came close to death, not regarding his life, to supply what was lacking in your service toward me." Now here's a Christian soldier, a man who died to himself and almost died physically in the service of Christ. God showed Paul and the church in Philippi and Epaphroditus, showed them all mercy in this case. He didn't die. But the word here is the reason he got so close to death because he had already died. Epaphroditus' life wasn't about Epaphroditus. Epaphroditus' life was about the Lord Jesus Christ, and it was about those that he ministered to. We just celebrated and remembered mothers on Mother's Day, and this is a great lesson we draw from you ladies, how you surrender your comforts and your desires to be a good mom. It's a great picture of the Christian life. It shows us the unconditional love God has for us. It shows us how we ought to love one another. And on Memorial Day, we thank God for those who gave their lives so that we could be free. But may it encourage us as Christians to be willing to lay down our life for the Lord Jesus and serve, by love, serve one another. Amen.